Okay, in this video we're going to continue with the result that we got last time for the integral form of the conservation of mass. So remember, here we're looking at an arbitrary volume like this potato in three dimensions, and we said that we can express the conservation of mass in this arbitrary volume in terms of two integrals. And these two integrals represent the accumulation term, d rho dt integrated over the volume. This is the accumulation of mass inside this volume. And an integral over the surface of rho v dot n dA. And that represents the net flow of mass through the surface area, right, into and out of the volume. So then, and this gives us an expression that we can apply to an arbitrary volume. So let's apply it to a specific problem that would be closer to the kinds of things that we would be interested in for chemical engineering, for fluid mechanics. And so, in particular, a lot of the problems that we deal with are related to flow through pipes or different kinds of channels. So imagine this situation. This is kind of a crazy pipe, but it's just it's a geometry. So this is in two dimensions here. So you have these sidewalls, and then these dashed lines are open surfaces, and I'm going to call these two stations one, kind of the entrance on the left hand side, and then the exit on the right hand side I'm going to call two, and we're going to consider steady state incompressible flow through this geometry. So it's a one-dimensional flow in the sense that it doesn't the flow doesn't vary. The velocity is uniform over the cross section, as you'll see here. So if I draw the flow going into this pipe, the velocity is uniform over the cross sectional area at some value V1, and then the flow exits here at point 2 with some velocity V2. And I also need to express the orientation of these surfaces. So surface 1 has a normal vector n1, and surface 2 has a normal vector n2. And remember, by convention, we define the normal vectors such that they're pointing from inside to outside of the system or the control volume that we're examining. So these are outward pointing normal vectors. Okay, so again, we're assuming that the velocity is constant over the cross-section, cross-sectional area. So that's what I've shown here. I tried to denote the velocity profile as flat. So let's apply the conservation of mass to this system. So remember, we have the accumulation term, integral of d rho dt over the volume, plus the integral over the area of rho v dot n dA equals 0. Steady state, nothing's changing with time, so this accumulation term goes to 0. And so we can cancel that out. And let me just redraw the geometry here on the next slide so I can continue. We have the flow in coming in at some velocity V1 and uniform flow out at some velocity V2. So we can look at the remaining term, the flow term. So notice that we said this was incompressible flow. So the density is constant. That factors out of the integral. And since this term is equal to 0, then this cancels out. And so we're left with the integral over the area of v dot n dA equals 0. So let's evaluate this now over the two surfaces where we have inflow or outflow, where we can have inflow or outflow. And so that's surface 1 and surface 2. So we can take the integral of v dot n dA over each of these surfaces. And notice that for surface 1, the velocity v1 is in the opposite direction as the normal vector. So the flow is coming in into the control volume, and the normal vector is pointing outward. So they have opposite sign, right? The normal vector points in the opposite direction of the velocity. If we come to surface 2, notice that the velocity the flow is leaving the control volume at the surface. And the normal vector also points outward. So N2 and V2 are in the same direction. So the signs are the same in this term. And since the velocity is constant over the cross section, then we can make an important assumption that allows us to basically pull that out of the integral. And so we just have minus V1 times the integral over surface 1 dA plus V2 times the integral over surface 2 of dA. And so the integral of dA over the area is just the area, A1, and similar for A2. So I get minus V1 A1 plus V2 A2 equals 0. So setting these two equal, I get an interesting result. I get that V1 A1 equals V2 A2 equals VA. And so remember that the product of the velocity times the cross-sectional area is the volume flow rate, right? Cubic meters per second. So conservation of mass over this kind of control volume that is like flow through a pipe gives me the result that the product of the velocity times the cross-sectional area is constant for the case of incompressible steady state flow. Remember the assumptions that we made. So an incompressible flow through a pipe, which is, remember we said that can be assumed generally for most liquids, the volume flow rate is constant. Okay, so what if the velocity is not uniform over the cross-sectional area? So instead of having a flat velocity profile, we could have, you know, a parabolic profile or some other kind of curve. Well, we can still use this relationship. This relationship still holds, but instead of the uniform velocity, we can define an average velocity and take the average velocity over the cross section. So the definition of an average, the mathematical definition of an average, is the integral over the cross-sectional area of whatever quantity you're trying to average. So in this case, we're averaging the normal component of the velocity. So the average velocity is 1 over the cross-sectional area times the integral of V dot NdA, or the flow rate over the cross-sectional area. So we can still, the relationship still holds if the velocity is not uniform, but instead of this constant velocity, we use the average velocity calculated using the mathematical definition of an average.